Hey everyone, Corvus here. Welcome to the fourth episode in the Triumph of St. Catherine project diary. So basically in the last video, we started painting, so put quite a big amount of time painting the separate figures. So the red and the lighter areas, they're basically done. Then at the end of the last video, just finished some black details there, but as you can see, there's quite some work left, especially the metallics, but also some of the other colored areas. Like there's some specials left and right, the smoke here, these rose petals, the candles that go everywhere. So there's plenty of detailing work to be done on these figures. But at the end of the previous episode, I switched my attention to Saint Catherine. The figure here in the bed or the coffin, I keep mixing up those names, but I think coffin or bed, just like to call it like that. So the end of the last video, I think I've been base coating the surface of the bed, so these cushions, these are now completely done. And then I continued painting the lighter areas here, the cloth, so you can see draped on here. And then after that, I did some decided to base coat, not really a base coat, but just with some thinned down Rhinox hide and with a bit of black there, thinned that down and just went over the entire figure, because I have to paint the bones and also usually do this with a neutral brown most of the time. I think it's a Steel Legion drap I use for that. Yeah, Steel Legion drap, so it's pretty neutral brown. And there are some plenty of hard to reach areas in here. So that's the reason I base coated the entire rest of the figure in this dark brown mix. Because yeah, I think the armor itself will be, I think it's also on the box art like that, that it's painted in this gold. I want to do, because yeah, also painting gold over a brown surface is quite easy to do. So we'll continue from there. Before we continue, I'd like to remind you that there will be links in the video description to Element Games, a website that gives you 10-15% off or even more on Warhammer kits or painting supplies or even board games. They have all kinds of stuff. So I please ask you to check that out if you're interested in buying this kind of stuff online with a discount. Please use the link in the video description. You can help out the channel with that. And also, during checkout, you can use the code GER959 for double the store credit. So I'm now going to turn off the camera and see you in the next section while I continue painting this figure here. So I've painted 2-3 hours now since the last update. So here the bed, I just been blocking off some areas in black to prepare them for the metallics that should be painted on here. And then I decided to move back to the single figure. So what I did first, I already painted some of the black here to prepare for the metallics as well. Just started painting some of the metallics here in Lead Belcher. So most of the backpacks are done. Like this is where the banner will go. The lower part is just going to be metal. And the top part is going to be gold, so just to have some variety here. Also on the backpack, there is this emblem here in front that's also going to be gold or bronze, I think, but for the most it will be just painted in metal. The other ones as well here, the backpack is mostly done, these chains, etc., the respirator here. And then I wanted to start painting the metallics here on the St. Catherine, but yeah, just there's some hard to reach areas, I realized, on some miniatures left and right, including St. Catherine's hair. So that's what I painted. Like I said, just wanted to have some kind of blue hue there. And also with the other figure, this one, also finished the hair. And the rest of the face, just needed the to finish the eyes on this one. Yeah, the hair looks a bit more subtle than on camera here, because there's quite some black in the frame. It's going to be a bit bit too light here to appear on camera, but in reality it's it looks pretty good. See, so yeah, basically where I stopped this session, we're with the hair and the eyes. So for next painting session, I'm probably just going to pick out some more details, like the scrolls here, the book I can do afterward, but just anything that can get in the way of painting metallics like this, here in this chalice, this smoke. Then I still need to prepare this one for metallics. So just going to paint this, I think, a dark brown, the scale itself. And then there's another one here. This also needs some, especially the, yeah, what are there? These Oreo cookies, not really, but which are in this chalice as well, around the chains. So something I want to finish also first. I think maybe on this one, that's not really required, but I'll look into this. And then I'm also might want to start working on the heart here before I finish the metallics around. I'm not sure yet, but we'll see how it goes then. Started working on the base, as you can see here. So going for two tones here. So this very light beige color and then a light gray. And I'm still going to have to paint some metallics on this. But yeah, this is fun piece to paint, in fact, this base. And then now I decided just to go take miniature by miniature, for example, this one here, take miniature by miniature and try to finish it as much as possible. So as you can see, I finished up some detailing here, the scrolls here, the book, are all details which are finished, and I'm working on the metallics of this one. And then probably just going to, yeah, figure by figure, finishing them up, retouching, stuff like that, so I can, yeah, start finishing up the figure phase of the project, and also going to finish the base, so I can attach the miniatures which are done. I can attach them on there, but still there's some work to be done, like these cherubs which fly above above this coffin which carry them, or this bed. I always keep mixing up the two terms, but these cherubs are there. There's this banner which still need to be painted mostly. The shield. So there are some details left, of course. So yeah, plenty of work to do. The previous section you've just seen was from a general update video that I do every once in a while here on the channel. So it was not really in line with the rest of this series, but nonetheless, I wanted to show you this in-between progress, because since the last video, there hasn't been any much filming going on. So there's going to be a bit of a bigger jump between the previous section and this section. So I thought what would be useful to include the section you just saw, where I showed some in-between progress on some of the individual miniatures and especially the base. So we're now a couple of hours further in the painting process. Like I said in the previous section, I am still going over each miniature individually and just trying to finalize the details on there. And then I'm processing now, I'm working on the metallics on all of these. And of course the base, we're going to have a close look on those in a minute. Other than that, these cherubs, yeah, they still have to be done. What I did here was with the airbrush, I base coated the wings basically with the airbrush. So that's the only thing that's done already on these guys. So I'll probably first finish the wings and then move on to the skin tones. And skin tones is also a bit special, because here on this part, the arms that are hanging here on the chains, or I mean the chains that are hanging on the arms, they also have to be done in the skin tone. So that's going to be a bit of a in between progress process there. But anyway, whoops. Let's move over to the base first. So what I did here with the, sorry. So like I said in the previous section, these are two tone of base. I think I quite like the layout of this base. I followed the box art mostly on this one, not really for the colors, but more like how the colors are laid out, especially here in the middle. I've included a third color, the brown, to get some extra contrast there around the sigil in the middle. In the end, I don't know how much will be visible when all the miniatures are on these, but on there. But I think this is a nicely detailed base. Also, these rose petals which are on here are the same color as the figures here in the background here, top right. So nice detail also there. And all, I think it was quite easy to paint this base. A lot of crisp detail on there. And like I said, I'm now working on these metal areas. So these bars you have running here in front of the stairs, in front of the steps, these are metallics. And then this logo here in the middle. And this still needs to be shaded with some washes, of course. But for the most part, this this base is done. So I'll now move on to the other individual miniatures. Like I said, this figure with the rose petals. So you'll see some of the details are done here on the miniatures in similar colors. I really like to limit, sometimes to the extreme, I really like to limit limit the colors that I use. So you also notice that the candles, which are on most of the backpacks, they're also done. These are done in exactly the same red as the cloaks, but yeah, the recipe of shading and highlighting is done differently, so it appears to be a bit of a different shade of red, but basically it is exactly the same color. And then this what I used for this is what I mentioned previously. It's also used on the other miniatures on some of the stages there. The Screamer pink, really nice violet color. That's what I used for the rose petals, and then some of the details like at the bottom of the cloak, for example, is also done in the same color. So that's the figure with the rose petals. And then this figure has this, yeah, I don't know the English word for it, but where this smoke comes out. And then there are these objects inside. I decided to give them both a different color. And this smoke, yeah, was fun to paint. Just went for a blue here, which is not visible on any other. Oh, there's one other miniature with some blue details on there. But I thought it was going to be a nice detail here. Really a bit of an eye catcher. The only blue, except for the other one, then in the entire miniature. And then there's this object that this figure is holding. Yeah, not really a fan of this object. I think it looks a bit strange, but also painted this in a rather light color. What's next? Our bed. Yeah, I'm working on the metallics, like the chains are painted, some of these candles also, this vessel which holds this heart. It's not visible on camera, but it's also painted in metallic, all base coated, and this the stones here which go on the base are painted in the same color. Then I have base coated some metallics here on the bottom part. I'm not sure how much of that will be visible. And then these small shields here on the sides, these symbols, they will be painted in gold, the same gold that will be painted, used on the armor. And then this figure you've seen in the previous section, not really much changed on that. So this detailing on the book, the scrolls, same as in the previous section, as you can see, I've painted on some of the metallics. They still need to be shaded and highlighted, of course. This is just base coated on. Then our Saint Catherine, bit similar story. The hair is painted, and then the metallics. Working on the metallics. So some of these edges on the armor, the sword, etc. Some details left and right. And then the other figure with the blue that I mentioned. There is also these on the box art. It's flames, but I didn't really like that. Just like to have this paint, this color used in this goblet, which will be painted in gold also. And with this one, the similar story, the backpack is painted in base coat in metallics already. These small signs here, like this candle, will be done in gold. Have some detail on there. So similar process with the other ones. And then finally this figure which holds this icon this heart icon is I also painted this, tried to do some kind of reflection effect here. Not really happy about how it turned out in the end. I did too many reflections, but I think from a distance it looks pretty good. I also did some lettering here on the scroll here on the side, and then same story, working on the metallics. So that's the process currently. So I'm moving on or continuing with the metallics on these, and then probably already start attaching some of the miniatures on the base to see how it looks. But the next big task will be working on these cherubs, and yeah, that's really when I start working, when these are done and I start working on the cherubs, then we're really starting the final stretch of this project. So see you in the next part.